note and in the last 10 minutes started the chapter adjectives, and we have learned about adjective of quality, adjective of quantity, adjective of number, demonstrative adjectives. Okay, we have done till part O. Now we will continue with part P, interrogative adjectives. What are interrogative adjectives? An adjective which, when used with a noun, an adjective when it is used with a noun asks a question. Okay, they are called interrogative adjectives. For example, three examples are given. What bird is this? Vansham, what are you doing? Rub this. What bird is this? In this sentence, the word what, it qualifies the noun bird. That means we are talking about a bird. Okay. And we are asking question, what bird is this? In the second sentence, whose purse is that? Third sentence, which book is yours? In all the three sentences, the words what, whose, which, they have been used as an adjective. In the first sentence, we are talking about bird. In second, we are talking about purse. And in the third sentence, we are talking about book. And we are asking questions. Since these adjectives used with nouns, like in the first sentence, bird is noun. Second sentence, purse is noun. In the third sentence, book is noun. Okay, they are used with nouns. Otherwise, we are using these W family words like what, which, whose, like what is your name? No noun is there. With what, there is helping verb. What is your name? But here, what bird is this? What is the difference between these two sentences? What bird is this means there is a, in this sentence, there is a noun after what, and the sentence, what is your name? There is no noun. Same with whose purse, which book. Okay, there are nouns after these words, after these interrogative words. Interrogative adjectives, you can say. So here, what, which, whose, these all are interrogative adjectives. Okay. And look at the sentence carefully. There is a question mark also. In interrogative sentences, we always put a question mark at the end. Okay. Next, very simple possessive adjectives. These adjectives show belonging. Okay. Like first example, this is my bag. That means this bag belongs to me. That is your bat. That means that bat belongs to you. Third, her umbrella is black. Umbrella belongs to her. That means the words which show belongings, they are called possessive adjectives. Okay. An adjective that shows possession or belonging, they are called possessive adjectives. Yes. A table is given below again for revision. Adjective of quality, that tell us what kind of color, size, shape, special quality, like old man, charming eyes, shady tree. What kind of man? Old. What kind of eyes? Charming. And what kind of tree? Shady. Okay. These tell us about what kind of. These are adjectives of quality. Next, adjectives of quantity. They tell us how much quantity tell us how much, like some water, much hope, enough money, water, hope, money, they all are uncountable nouns. Next, adjectives of numbers. Adjective of number tell us how many. They are countable nouns, like four girls, many toys, all the books. Then we have done demonstrative adjectives. They use to point out the person or thing, like this, that, plural of this and that, plural for this is these, and plural for that is those, and such. Okay, such is also an example of demonstrative adjective. Next, we have done today interrogative adjective. Help to ask questions. Which boy? What plan? Whose bag? Okay. And the last one, possessive adjectives. Show possession or belonging. My chair, that means that chair belongs to me. Your school, that school belongs to you. Her eyes, these all are showing possession or belonging. Okay. And the words first, second, they are also adjective of numbers. They are ordinal numbers. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. They are included in the adjective of number. Next, question words like what, whose, which can be interrogative adjective only if they are followed by a noun. What, whose, which, they are interrogative. Adjective only if is that here whose is followed by a noun purse, but whose is this purse? Here whose is not followed by a noun in sentence, it is not followed by a noun. So this is here whose is not an adjective. Okay. And words like some, enough, all, adjective of quantity. If they suggest quantity, some milk, enough food, then they are used as adjective of quantity. But sometimes the same adjectives are used with countable nouns, like some books. Books are countable. Enough people. People are countable. So here we are using them as an adjective of number. Okay. Next, pick out the interrogative and possessive adjectives in the following sentences. Arrange them in columns. First one, what time are you leaving for your school? What time? Here, what is an interrogative adjective? Time are you leaving for your school? This word is showing belonging, possession. So, your is possessive adjective. Okay. What is interrogative and your is possessive adjective. In the second sentence, whose books is Winnie belonging in her hand? Whose books? Here, whose is followed by a noun, book. That's why whose is an interrogative adjective. And her is showing belonging, her hand. So her is possessive adjective. Next. Which boy needs my help? Which boy? Again, this is followed by a noun. My help. My is possessive adjective. Fourth, which tools does the carpenter need to start his work? Which tools? Again, this is followed by a noun. So interrogative adjective. Then his work. This is possessive adjective. Next sentence, what gift have you brought for your friend? What is interrogative adjective? It is followed by the noun gift. And Your is possessive. Adjective. In sixth sentence, whose bag is lying on my desk? Whose bag is lying on my desk? Whose is interrogative adjective followed by noun bag? My desk. Here, my is possessive adjective. What kind of animal are these? What kind of animals are these? Here, what is interrogative adjective and no possessive adjective is there. No word is showing belonging. Eighth sentence, which is your bed? Here, which is not followed by any noun. So there is no interrogative adjective. Your word shows the belonging. So your is possessive adjective. Which bed is yours? Again, which is followed by a noun bed. Which bed is yours? Again, yours showing belonging. So this is possessive adjective. And the last one, whose painting did you like the most? Again, given below. Okay. Two columns are there, interrogative adjectives and possessive adjectives. You have to write these according to the words, adjectives you have underlined in the above sentences. Okay. Yes, I think this is clear to you. Now, next part, underline the adjectives in the following story. Listen very carefully. We will do line wise. First one, palace with beautiful gardens. Here, first of all, find out the adjectives. Which are the adjectives in this great and beautiful palace. Next, there was a small lake nearby. There was a small lake nearby. Small is an adjective, again, adjective of quality. What kind of lake? Small lake. Next sentence. Once, when the prince wore a green turtle, any color? I have told you they are adjectives, adjectives of quality. What kind of turtle? Green. And ran back to the palace in fear. Okay. Next paragraph. First sentence. There is a terrible demon lying on the bank of the lake. What kind of demon? Terrible. Again, adjective of quality. They said to their father, this adjective show possession or belonging. So this is possessive adjective. Next, the king sent two servants to bring this demon to the court. Servants, how many? Adjective of number. This demon, this is adjective of, this is an example of demonstrative adjective. Okay, which words are included in demonstrative adjective? This, that, these, those, and such. Okay, next, soon the turtle was placed in his presence. His is an adjective, a possessive adjective here. This was belonging. Since he had never seen her, he too felt afraid of it. No adjective is there. Kind of shell? Hard shell, quality of the turtle carefully and said to his minister. His is an adjective of possession. Possessive adjective is this armor. What method should be used to kill him? What method? What is an interrogative adjective? Then let us grind him to powder, said the first minister. First, ordinal number, adjective of number. That will not be. In the last, there is a word easy. What kind of method? That will not be an easy method. What kind of method? Easy method. So easy. Second minister. This is again adjective of number. Ordinal number is there. So this is adjective of number. Next, let us put him in a hot oven. What kind of oven? Hot oven. So hot is an adjective of quality. Next, let us throw him into the lake at the place where the water flows over the rocks into the river, suggested the third minister. Third is an adjective of number. Then the turtle was happy at the last suggestion. Happy, adjective of quality. But he said, don't treat me with such cruelty. Here is a word, such before the word cruelty. Okay. I'm going to show you. Just wait. Here is a word. Such. So this is an adjective, a demonstrative adjective. Okay. Now, the king immediately ordered his servants. These servants belong to king. So his possessive adjective. To throw him into the water. Again, the clever. Here, the word clever. The clever turtle laughed as he swam down the river to his home in the sea. The clever turtle. What kind of turtle? Clever. So this is adjective of quality. Laughed as he swam down the river to his home. His is again here showing possession. So this is adjective of possession, possessive adjective you can see. Okay. Yes, students. Now, the last part of this chapter. The puzzle given below involves adjectives. Solve it by filling the adjectives opposite in meaning. Okay, some adjectives are given. You have to fill the puzzle by using their opposites. First one is, now we are doing across. Okay, first is brought. We are doing this one. Broad, and opposite of broad is narrow. NARROW. These both are adjectives. Okay, adjectives of quality. Next, we are doing sixth one, kind. We are doing this one. Opposite of kind is cruel. CRUEL. Next, we are doing eighth one, true. Here it is. True, very simple. Opposite of true is false. FALSE, false. Then, ninth one, bold. Opposite of bold is timid. TIMID. Tenth one, polite. Opposite of polite is rude. RUDE, rude. Next, 11th, proud. Opposite of proud is humble. HUMBLE, humble. Next, 13th, cheap. Opposite of cheap is costly. Again, I am repeating. Broad, narrow. Kind, cruel. Eighth one, true, false. Bold, timid. Tenth, polite, rude. 11th, proud, humble. 13th, cheap, costly. Now, downwards. First is safe. Opposite of safe is dangerous. DANGEROUS, dangerous. Second is bad. Opposite of bad. FRONT, front. Third, ancient. Opposite of ancient is modern. MODERN, modern. Next, fifth, fine. Opposite of fine is coarse. Next, seventh, loose. Opposite of loose is tight. T-I-G-H-T. And the last one, 12th one, worst. Opposite of worst is best. Okay. Now, sorry, one more part is there. Very simple part. Add Y, L-Y, I-S-H or F-U-L to form adjectives. Y, L-Y, I-S-H, F-U-L. First star, you have to add here. You have to add here F-U-L, useful. Then love, lovely. You have to add here L-Y. Very simple. I think you can do this part yourself also. Okay. Students, now we are going to unmute all of you so that you can ask any question if you want.